This is the Teddi Tuesday Podcast Show.
It's Teddi Tuesday, Teddi Tuesday, 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 Teddi Tuesday, Tuesday, Teddi Tuesday, 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 Teddi Tuesday Podcast Show.
Yo, what's up? It's me, DJ Teddi, and today we're talking about sports, community, and business. That's right, we're getting ready for the 2019 year the right way. The only way, and we're doing it Texas style, B-I-G. Stay tuned every Tuesday. Presented to you by Fort Bend Dental. Let's go.
Yo, what's up, what's up? Thank you, everybody, for coming out tonight. Give yourself a round of applause. Welcome to Teddi Tuesday. I got a couple shout-outs. You know, as a DJ, you know, we like to talk on the mic. Some of us, not all of us. And we're going to get into the football game, so don't worry. We're going to talk about some of these teams and what they did. We ain't going to name no names right now, but we're going to get into it in a few minutes. But first of all, I want to thank my sponsors, Fort Bend Dental, the American Flag Football League, of course, Ice Ici Company up in the building, my family, too. They're not my sponsors, but you got to thank the fam, too. LG Steppers are in the building. Y'all give them a round of applause. Representing. Hey, I'm feeling the energy. Let me tell you something. Even if it's just one of you representing your team, you gotta come with it. You can't be ashamed to represent what you build or what you a part of. Even if it's just you, stomp it. Hey, what's up? What's up? We're here, so we appreciate the positivity and everybody being here. Remember, $2 Tuesdays, it goes down every Tuesday. We got drink specials and all that good stuff. Shout out to Texas Liquor Brewery. They're also a sponsor of the show. We got Don Elliott all the way from Warren, Texas in the building. Y'all make some noise. Y'all make some noise. Y'all see that big old truck right there? It even smell fresh. It smell better than me, real talk. Like, it smell good. Big wheels, the tires bigger than me, but it looks good. That's Don Elliott. These guys right here, even with the crutches, they part of the team right here, part of the team. So, Don Elliott, they have a couple locations. If you need to know, if you're getting ready to buy you a new car, a new vehicle, a business car, whatever it might be, talk to them. Justin, see this guy right here at the end. Justin, wave your hand. Talk to him. Are we giving away that voucher today? Hey, I got some good news. Y'all came on a good Tuesday, I'm going to tell you. Today, I partner up with Don Elliott. We're giving a $500 voucher for a brand new car. $500 towards a brand new car. A $500 voucher. So that's pretty dope. So I'm going to give that away today. So anyway, we're going to get into the show. I appreciate everybody coming out tonight. Of course, I am DJ Teddi. If you don't know me, follow me on I Am DJ Teddi. Shout out to my team. Everybody's rocking the shirts. I couldn't do it without them. So I'm just letting you know, everybody's rocking the shirt. I couldn't do it without them. We got everybody working tonight. Everybody working. Everybody. We all sweating up in here. So shout out to all the sponsors. The King James. If you was here last week and you got into some dope music, it was from this gentleman right here with the hat. The King James III. He's a producer, work with BET and some other things. So if you need you a good intro song, like the one you just heard, hit him up. LNG Steppers, you need an intro? I mean, I'm just saying. That's the man to talk to right there. What's up, Kenny? I see you like the back of the bus back there. I see you. I appreciate it. Anyway, my name is DJ Teddi. If you don't know, you can follow me. I'm DJ for the Houston Texans, the Houston Dash. I've been in so many stadiums, and I'm glad to be a part of this to open up jobs for other people so we can be more entrepreneurs instead of just clocking in. I'm tired of just clocking in. What? I can't read my button. I'm going to get it, though. Anyways, make sure you follow us on our Instagram at Teddi Tuesday Pod. That's Teddi Tuesday Pod on Instagram. And on YouTube. The first episode, which was last week, it is on the YouTube channel. Matter of fact, it's downloading right now. And it is Teddi Tuesday Pod TV. Teddi Tuesday Pod TV on YouTube. Make sure you go check out that recap video from last week. That was episode number one. And the website for Teddi Tuesday will drop in February. We will have our own website. We're not hooking up with anybody. We're going to have our own identity. I just refuse. We're going to do it ourselves. So, shout out to, of course, 713 Printers in the building. If you need LNG Steppers, if y'all need some banners like this one right here, if you need anything marketing-wise, we got a gentleman in the back that you need to see. Don Elliott, if y'all need something, anything, banners for the trucks when you guys go out, we got a gentleman right here. He can help you out. You know how y'all get the magnets on your truck or whatever. Whatever you need marketing, hit up Paul. He's in the back. He'll be more than happy to direct you to the right people so you can get the right marketing materials. And let me tell you this, From an entrepreneur standpoint, marketing is so important. Don't be sloppy and don't be cheap. It will come back. And that's for everybody. So make sure you hit them guys up. They got good prices. They're reliable and you're right here in your backyard. You know what I'm saying? So make sure you use that. All right. Let's get into the game. DJ, you ready to get into the game? We're going to talk about these football games. We got some football fans in the building? Anybody watch the game?
Yeah.
I'm gonna ask questions. You better answer the questions. I'm going to ask them. All right. Saturday, we have the Colts versus the Kansas City. Anybody watch that game? Wes, tell me about that game. What did you see that was interesting at the game?
The Colts got beat.
He make it short and sweet. The Colts just got beat. It is what it is. Kansas City.
You
know, actually, I didn't. They did Texans so bad. You know, they really did. They really embarrassed us. But I knew Kansas City was going to win. Patrick Mahomes is an outstanding young quarterback. I mean, he's very versatile. If you've ever watched him play, he is great. I look forward to seeing him actually go to the Super Bowl if he doesn't make it this time. I look for next year. See, that's something that we need something like that. You know, Texas, we need something. Also, where my Dallas fans at? You know, you play the song extra long for Dallas. Ain't nobody else gonna. My goodness gracious. Dallas played the Rams. That's all we're gonna say about that. The Rams won. It was 22-30. So it was a close game. Dallas, does anybody know what was the issue why Dallas didn't win? Can anyone sum it up? Anybody? Offense, defense, what was it? Talk to me. I'll listen. I'll talk back.
They stopped the run. They couldn't run.
Was it Ezekiel or was it the coaching or what?
No, it wasn't Ezekiel. When you have a defense like the Rams, you're not gonna go very far.
You're just not gonna go nowhere. You're just not gonna go nowhere. So Dallas is out. Now I don't know if you guys saw it, but I think it was Terrell Owens made a tweet about the coaching staff about Dallas. So.
Oh, yeah.
He did put it out there, well, y'all need to get y'all, you know, but Jerry Jones is one of those owners that he do what he want, when he want, and how he want. He'll come down and coach the team himself, right from the suite. Okay, no, he said he can't even run that ball. Prescott, y'all do, you know, that's what that type of general manager is. But Dallas did lose. I look forward to him to be a little bit more productive. Their offensive line. What you say, y'all over there talking while I'm talking? This is class. No, I'm just joking. Okay, up next we got the Chargers versus the Patriots, 28-41. I'll be honest with you, I knew the Patriots was going to lose. I mean, I knew the Chargers, I'm sorry. I knew the Chargers were going to lose. I'll be honest with you. Patriots have too many weapons, too many advantages. So that was going to be the end of that. So 28-41, so Patriots move on. Philly versus Saints. Anybody watch that game?
Yeah.
Philly fan?
Woo!
Don't be saying any New Orleans Saints fans? Oh, no.
Hey,
Dick,
you
want to save you?
Can we get
it
back and go?
Oh, that's in the case. Boy. I'm going to tell you what.
How many
if you did not watch the game, the score was 14. What was that?
How many teams you got?
How many
DJ, how many teams you got?
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
He put you out there, didn't he?
I'm from New Orleans, but I only got one team.
Okay. Okay, so anyway, Philly versus Saints, 14-20. Up next, we're going to have Patriots versus Kansas City. That is going to be the game to watch. Let me tell you, talent will be on the line and drive will be on the line. We will see who got it. Patriots have all, you know, one thing I like about the Patriots, they're organized, they're patient. And they got a lot of experience. So they know what to do when it's time to do it. So shout out to Patriots, but I hope Kansas City win. I don't know about you, but I don't want to see Patriots in the Super Bowl. I'm tired of seeing them. I'm tired of looking at Tom Brady making checks, making me mad. You know, golly, share some of the wealth, brother. So I hope to see Kansas City. So if you have not watched the game, you can always come back here every Tuesday. I'm going to give you a recap of what's going on, who's winning, And remind you, Super Bowl Sunday, speaking of which, February the 3rd, Super Bowl Sunday, we will have a watch party right here. We're getting a big screen right behind me, and we will have a watch party. We're going to have Savage, who's a car club. They're going to be here. I'm going to be here. We're going to have Southern Connection here, too, as well, performing for halftime. So if you are in town or around, we're having a watch party right here with a big screen, and I'm going to be right here in front because I'm short, so I'm just letting you know. So we're having a right here at 5 p.m. That's right, 5 p.m. So let you know, watch party right here. So come and join me. We're going to have a good time. All right, we're going to get into the quote of the day. And I do this because I have a lot of people surrounding me and some people here, like L&G Steppers and other people, that are entrepreneurs. Either they work a full-time job and they do their dream part-time. And what I tell my group of people is that if you can go and clock in to work every day for 6 a.m. for somebody else, when it comes to doing what you want to do, you need to have that same structure and enthusiasm for yourself. Give yourself the same standards. Some people forget. When it comes to dreaming, well, I'll just do it later. 20 years roll by, 30 years, and you still stuck where you were. So I just want to remind people to challenge yourselves on a daily basis. I'm an entrepreneur. There is no 9-to-5 but myself, but I still work 24 hours a day. I'm very proud about that. I'm very excited about that. So if I can pave the way, in order to be great, you have to have structure. And you have to have courage to stand on your own. If you want to be the same as everybody else, then stay the same. But if you want to challenge yourself and be better, like the other people, we live in a world now where social media, you can get rich. Literally off of social media. You can get rich off of making technology, apps, and all this good stuff. People just diddle down. You can do things as long as you believe in yourself, but you have to have courage to do what you feel on the inside and make it work for you on the outside. And I say that all the time to the camp. Don't settle. I'm going to say it again. Do not settle. The quote of the day is, stop chasing the money and start chasing the passion. With money, you can nickel down, but with passion, that can buy you a house and some land. Passion will set you apart from other people. Money won't. It'll make you comfortable, but it won't. So to all my entrepreneurs out there, them innovators, no matter what your age is, I know somebody that's 60 years old starting a business. I said, go after it. I know somebody who's 9 years old and parents are behind them, they're starting their business. So it doesn't matter the age, it just matters the drive. So just keep that in mind when you're going day to day. This is a part of Teddi Tuesday. I'm here to encourage. I'm here to give you the sports. And somebody's phone ringing. I can hear it from the corner. I'm just messing. But anyways, check this out. Now we got the interview. This is Ice Ice Company. Y'all make some noise for Wes. Y'all make some noise for Wes. He all fresh and smelling good. I'm going to have to ask him, can I borrow some of their cologne every now and then? Because it's smelling good. You know what I'm saying? This is... you're going to get in trouble. Don't put me in that. Don't put me in that. But this is Wes. He is the owner of the Icy Ice Company, that Texas logo up there. I'm gonna let him tell you about himself and what he does, so you can kind of get the feel of how he can benefit you. You guys that have festivals, crawfish bowls, those gas stations, or anything. This is the guy you want to talk to right here. So I'm gonna let him introduce himself. And we got somebody stepping for life. I can see the T-shirt right here. Right now, you good right here? They're on the second row, brother. Second row. You with them? And we lie. We don't care. We're just real. This real right here. All right, let's go ahead.
Oh, okay, well, thanks, Teddi. Thanks for having me tonight. Appreciate Fuzzy's Taco for having us here. And thanks for all the sponsors. And just to recap on how I got started, is kind of what she was saying, is about 20 years ago, I turned in my keys, my pager, back then it was pager, not phone.
Ooh, pages.
Yeah, and the company truck, everything, and took a chance, and here we are today. So she's right about that. You just have to, you know, take it. It's we all gamble every day. Driving down the road, we gamble. So it's a big gamble, but you know, if you have enough passion and enough heart, you can make anything happen. But yeah, it was a long road, but you know. It gets, you know, easier and easier, I guess I could say, after, you know, when you get going. But anyway, what we do is pretty much anything where ice cubes go. about 10 years ago, I found another way to, you know, in this time of the year where it's slow, it's cold, we actually make snow. So, and then I built some slides, so we put the snow on the slides, and then the kids slide down the snow. So, it's just another avenue to you know, have another way to get rid of ice.
Oh, yeah.
So,
And I tried the snow slide. I'm telling you, it's really fun, you know, but you gotta be a little bit small. I'm a little thick, so you slide right, but you know. It's all good. It's for all sizes. It's really dope. So check this out. It's amazing that he said he quit his job. That's kind of amazing. That's dope. When you really believe in yourself, I'm telling you, it's nothing like paying your bills with your dream. It's a different type of payment. It feels good. But anyways, let me ask you this, Wes. What makes Icy Ice Company different from any other ice company in the city?
I think we, the right way to say it, we do many things. Some ice companies just deliver ice, like you said, to ATV or to gas stations. We not only do retail, we do wholesale, we do snow, we do many different
avenues.
Yeah, wherever ice is needed, we do dry ice. I mean, anything that you need to make it.
That's pretty dope.
So,
and let me tell you something. If people think ice is important, it's what you drink. For some of you guys, when you have when you go out to these restaurants, they have those big old sodas and they have ice in it. So ice is very important. You want clean ice. You don't want no nasty ice. You be drinking all of everything. I'm serious. Ice is very important. And when you go to restaurants, when they put ice in your water, you want good ice from a good company, because you're drinking that and it can be contaminated. So you want to get it from somewhere where it's reliable. Turn the mic down just a bit. All right, next question. Can you give some examples of places where Icy Ice is used, such as like family reunions, crawfish bowls, and what else?
We do parties at your house if you want to do a Super Bowl party.
Hey!
You don't want to mess around with going to the store and getting all the bags and all that. We'll bring it right to your house.
Oh, that's dope.
Yeah.
Delivery. Save on gas. That's what you need to do.
Well, a lot of times you're too busy cooking and trying to make the ribs and the brisket and all that kind of stuff.
Gumbo, so, yeah.
So, yeah, so you want to, you know, save on time that way.
So it's mobile. That's pretty good. And can people rent, you know, we have trail rides and stuff like that. So can you rent the ice trailers and the ice boxes for events and concerts?
We do. We have these ice boxes on trailers. And if you're doing an event or any kind of party, we load it up with ice, we go deliver it, we plug it in, and it stays frozen. You take out any bags of ice as you need it, and it's all frozen.
Wow.
No problems.
That's pretty dope. What's the funnest thing about your job?
Well, it's the coolest job in the world, right?
He caught me off guard, but that was good. I was like, what? Okay, got you. Yeah, that was good.
If I got a minute, let me tell you a little story.
You got a minute?
Of all people, there was this lawyer, and he said that his girlfriend had said that he would marry him if it snowed.
Wow.
And, you know, here in Texas, we don't, you know, in Houston, we don't get that much snow. So he called me and said, I want it to snow at my house.
Wow.
So we made it snow at his house.
Well, I guess they got it done, didn't they? You can always work your way around.
I don't know if he got the right answer, but, you know, yes or no. It's no.
If you brought it to the house, somebody going to be saying, yes, that costs. Last question I have for you. For the snow rentals, which we saw one out here before, is can we rent those year-round, or are they just in the wintertime? Because, you know, it's hot in the summer. I can use a snow slide in June.
Well, our season for that is November to February. And the reason for that is July, August, there's not much left. You know, once we blow the snow, you're not going to get your money's worth, because it's going to melt so fast. It's going to be, you know, slush and mud, and, you know, so we found that November to February is the best times to do that.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Y'all make some noise, show some love for Icy Ice. We trying to get the sound right. This is only our second episode, but we gonna get it right and get it tight. Up next, you know, the podcast is only 30 minutes. Okay. And he cuts me off. Golly. Messing up the church's money. I'm just playing. The podcast is every Tuesday. It's only 30 minutes because I want people to be able to network, to socialize, gather themselves. It's midweek and sometimes, you know, Monday morning we're a little sluggish. So Fuzzies allow us to get a couple drinks and socialize and eat real good. And just celebrate entrepreneurship, celebrate our neighborhoods, our back doors, Fort Bend County. Fort Bend County has a lot of things going on, a lot of businesses, and we're growing by the day. So this is a platform to celebrate any business, whether you're a dancer, whether you're a DJ, whether you're a producer, whether you are a realtor, whatever it is, a fisherman or Icy Iceman or a graphic designer. This is an opportunity, a platform, and a stage for you to display what you have. People don't know you unless you display it and be in your own community. You can't be silent in your own community. So that's what Teddi Tuesday, what we do. Make sure that you come back for Super Bowl weekend. We're here every single Tuesday. Okay, every single Tuesday. And if you need merchandise, Teddi Tuesday hats or Teddi Tuesday shirts, hit up one of my guys. We do have that for sale. Support us. We're trying to make it happen in ways that people have never seen. We are the very first live podcast, the very first, probably very first in Fort Bend County to have live music, a live podcast, and to be able to have giveaways and support local businesses. There's no other podcast that is doing it in a live atmosphere. So we are the first. And up next, what I'm going to do is Don Elliott. You got the certificate? You got it? Oh, no. Okay, fine. What I'm going to do, I'm going to give everybody a ticket in the next 2 minutes. And I'm going to draw from that ticket. And the winner will get $500 off. A certificate, $500 off a brand new vehicle from Don Elliott. And they have a big lot. I bought my Jeep Renegade from here. So they're very good. 2018, by the way. So they're very good. Up next, we're going to have live music. I want L and G Steppers to come and do a little something for us, if you don't mind. And then I'm going to get everybody a ticket, and we're going to draw from that ticket while they stepping. And it's just going to be music for the rest of the day. And I appreciate everybody coming out. I'll see you next Tuesday. Don't be cutting the music going until I'm done. I'm just messing, y'all. I just got a sense of humor. Anybody that know, they just laughing. But I appreciate everybody for coming out. Thank you for all the sponsors. Let me tell you, if you need anything, let me know. State Farm is in the back. If you need anything with your business, entrepreneurship, your family, hit up State Farm. If you need marketing material, 713 Printer is here, from banners to flyers to brochures. Get yourself right for what you want. And Icy Ice is here. I'm going to have to get with him for the trail rides or something like that. We're going to build us a horse sculpture or something. Do something good. This is Teddi Tuesday Podcast Show. I'm DJ Teddi. Let me get the LG stuff.